Welcome to our channel, Smart Kid Journey.
Namaste, I am Hema. We have been running Chiguru Montessori for 5 years. Chiguru Montessori is an authentic Montessori environment. We are a trained, certified adult here. He is Mr. Vasant.
Namaste everyone.
She is Pavitra auntie.
Namaste.
She is with us past 3 years.
Thank you, Hema. You know, today we are here because Janani is our child and she is running our own YouTube channel. And today we would like to talk about our house of children, the Chiguru Montessori. Let us learn about the Montessori and the method.
First, we need to understand Montessori method, right? We should know about Dr. Maria Montessori. She is a Maria Montessori. Vasant, why can't you talk about few words about Maria Montessori?
Definitely, Hema. I would love to talk about Dr. Maria Montessori. You know, Dr. Maria Montessori was born in Italy on August 31st in the year 1870. Maria, as a child, was been very optimistic, very positive and active child. She always did her academics very well, as well as she's been really good at sports and games. After pursuing basic education, Maria wanted to pursue her medicine. You know, at that time in Italy, it was also like medicine was not allowed for women particularly. But Maria didn't leave. She made her efforts. She went and joined the university and started learning medicine. And she was the only lady in the entire class of that year. So she is the first doctor in the Italy itself. During her medical education, Maria pursued philosophy and psychology. After finishing her medical, Maria practiced for several years and she was also called back to the university to continue as a professor. After working several years as a professor at the university, because of her experience, Maria was asked to start a school for children. It was one of the developmental project, particularly in the slums in the Italy, that Maria was asked to start school and help children to learn. Upon the request for starting the school, Dr. Maria Montessori started her first school in the slums of the Italy, and the school name was Casa di Bambini. You know, Casa di Bambini means the children's house. That is exactly the reason every Montessori, particularly authentic Montessori, is always called as house of children. We never say school, and we also address our teachers as aunties who help children to learn, and the helpers as akka in our school. So the house of children is nothing but a preschool which helps the children to learn from the age group of 2 to 6 years.
Montessori method is an activity-based learning method. It has 5 corners. Pavitra auntie, can you explain what is that 5 corners?
Yeah. The 5 corners are exercise of practical life, sensorial, language, arithmetic and culture. Under culture, children will learn science activities, zoology, botany, history and geography. And also we have play time, story time, circle time, singing time and dancing.
Wow! Children learn so much here at Montessori and it is amazing. I'd never heard children learn all this so much of knowledge from any other preschool. Montessori's curriculum itself is so vast. And in fact, there is a notion, is it a pressure on children that it is forcefully given so many topics to learn, but children are just like blank paper. They are ready to grasp as much as information you provide and in a planned and proper way, and they will learn everything. So that is what the approach Maria Montessori taught us, and we've been helping children to learn here. Do you know, because of the improvement that seen in the Casa di Bambini, which was in the slum area, in fact the then queen of Italy also visited and she was amazed by the improvement in the children, and their learning was on par with any other school, regular school children. That is exactly what Casa di Bambini did. In fact, Maria Montessori started observing children and developed the entire concept of Montessori right at the Casa di Bambini itself. Montessori House of Children serves the children of the age group from 2 to 6, that is the preschool age. The 2 to 6 year itself is considered as the most effective sensitive period. During this age, children's learning is at high peak. It is very important for the House of Children or any other schools, and as well as for the parents, to understand, give a proper planned learning base for children. This is going to lay a very strong foundation for the children, which carries through entire life. For the work Dr. Maria Montessori did and invented the Montessori method, she was also nominated 3 consecutive years for the Nobel Peace Prize. Very regretfully, it was not awarded for whatever reasons. As we all know, the central government has introduced a new education policy this year. The education policy key focus is on giving a child-centric education, a future-centric education, make children confident that carries to their entire life, and also the emphasis given on the local language and the mother tongue of the children. Very interestingly, Montessori does exactly the same thing. In fact, Montessori 100% in alignment with the new education policy. The purpose of Montessori itself is to make children independent. That starts from the exercise of practical life and learning sensitively, sensorially, from the sensorial section, arithmetic, language. Language is also taught in the phonetic based method, where children utter sounds rather than pronounce a different sound. For example, A is pronounced as A, that is exactly we pronounce in act. So likewise, it is a phonetic based language learning. Under culture, as Auntie mentioned, there's several activity children learn here. In fact, the curriculum itself is so vast, and children happily learn here without any force. One of the other thing that Montessori focus is, children learn at their own focus, and as well as children learn in the mixed group. The elder children help the younger children. The younger children learn by looking at the elder children working. That is the Montessori environment. Likewise, every authentic Montessori is determined to make children independent and very much self-resilient and Atmanirbhar. Exactly, the Montessori education system itself is very much Atmanirbhar education system. In fact, there is a wrong notion among parents that Montessori is an expensive method, but it is not at all expensive and very much affordable compared to any other traditional method schools.
We would like to say thank you for Janani parents, Anita Garu and Murli Garu. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Namaste, Mr. Murli.
Namaste.
And we are very happy with what you're doing. I'm sure this video is going to help a lot of children to understand about Montessori method. Your child, Janani, has been here since the age of 2 years. Now she's in the N3. And we would like to know from you that how was your experience with Chiguru Montessori? And how do you feel about Janani's learning here and the progress she has made all these 3 years? So please tell us your feelings.
Namaste to all. Myself, Murali. My daughter name is Janani. She is 4 years old. Recently, she started her YouTube channel. Channel name is Smart Kid Janani. Many of her viewers and subscribers requested about her school and education system. After referred by my friend, we came to Chiguru Montessori for inquiring about the admission. Once we reach here, we are impressed about the environment and way of teaching. So we joined Janani in Chiguru Montessori at the age of 2 years. She is a Montessori student studying M3 at Chiguru Montessori. Basically, Montessori means each and every topic they will explain by using the materials. Practically, they will explain everything and individual attention on each child. It helps to every kid to understand easily. We observed Janani because of Montessori education. She is independent, very bold, and easily connecting to the social life. As a parents, we are so happy about Montessori education. Many thanks to Chiguru team providing a great foundation to our child Janani.
Thank you so much, Mr. Murli, for your sweet words.
This is sensorial activity, Pink Tower. Pink Tower helps the child to understand height, width, and breadth. Pink Tower always children's favorite activity. Wow, Janani, awesome. This is geometrical solids. Square here. All the sides we have squares. This is cube. Square, pyramid. Rectangle. Here we have square. This is cuboid. This is prism. Triangular, prism. Circle. This is cylinder. This is cone. This is triangular pyramid. This is sphere. This is ellipsoid. This is ovaloid.
As a traditional method, generally how we learn, we will see half of the part of the geometrical solids, half of the shapes we are going to imagine. Here, children are going to touch and feel and learn the names.